Gareth A. Davies is one of the biggest boxing and MMA reporters out of England. We're here, we're talking to him. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm good, thank you. How are you doing?
We're here seconds after Canelo Lara, very emotionally charged post-fight press conference that I've seen. Have you seen anything like this in boxing or MMA?
Yeah, it happens.
Not very often.
Look, I mean, you have to judge. People judge the different styles tonight, and you know, there's a divided opinion. There's some people thought Canelo won it by a wide margin. Some people thought the fight was close. Other people had it a draw. Other people had it marginally for Eris Landilada. Now, it's down to the two styles, Ellie. I think you know that Canelo. It was always going to be the bull and the matador in there tonight. I mean, I wrote about that in my tweets during the fight. And for me, in the first half of the fight, the bull was getting shown up by the matador. But the bull came strong at the end. And you know, the last six rounds, who would have wanted to be Eris Landilada in there? I'd rather have been Canelo. He was taking the fight to Lara. He hurt him with a left uppercut. I think it was in the seventh or eighth. Made a big welt under his right eye, cut his right eye. Canelo was never in trouble in that fight physically. He was never troubled by Eris Landilada. He got caught by counters occasionally. I mean, you look at the punch stats, they tell a different story. But the fight I saw was very close for the first half of the fight. Maybe Lara marginally ahead, but then Canelo probably winning the last six rounds for me, five, six rounds, because he was patient. He was wild in the first half of the fight, patient in the second half of the fight, closed the angles, landed a lot of body shots, and punished Lara. Lara wasn't meeting him in many ways, and the trouble is, you have a rematch, which they're calling for afterwards, you're going to get the same fight. It's not, unless Lara changes tactics, you can't disagree completely with Lara's team either. It's hit and not be hit, and that's what he went out to do. But it's, in a way, it's one style is like amateur boxing. He doesn't box like Mayweather. I don't care what people say. Mayweather stands with you a bit more. He doesn't dance around you in the same way. And one style is perhaps amateur style boxing. Not that he's not a great mover, because Lara is. But I, you know, they're going to call for a rematch. It's not going to happen. They're going to put Canelo in with, I don't know who next, but it'll
maybe
be Cotto.
What do you think? What do you think of that fight?
That's a fantastic fight. That is one that you've got to be at. That's one that sells massively. Mexicans,
where?
The Puerto Ricans,
New York, or Vegas.
It's always a bigger fight here. But you know, they might want to take Canelo to New York. But you know that they're moving into Puerto Rican territory there, aren't they?
Yeah.
It's going to be West Side Story.
It's
going to be West Side Story if they go up there.
I hope it's in Vegas. There's nothing like fights in Vegas. So, to all the people back home in England watching, what did you think? How did you score this fight?
This is an internet show, Ellie.
That's true. You're right. Worldwide. You're right. I stand corrected. How would you score this?
How did I score the fight?
Yes.
I've got the scores here. I've got my scores here. I went some. I'm pretty sure I had it 3-3 in the first. I can't find them now. I'm pretty sure I had it 3. Right, I had them even
at 6.
I had Lara winning 1-3 and 6. Alvarez 2-4 and 5. But you know, they were close rounds, a lot
absolutely
of those.
Absolutely, could have gone either way.
But then from 7 onwards, that left uppercut was in the 7th round. I'm looking at my notes now.
Yeah.
And, you know, there's my scoring there. And from the 7th onwards, and I was totting it up. I had Canelo, you know, winning all those rounds. Because I thought he took the fight to Lara, you know. Look, Lara looked like a very unhappy man when he came to the press conference dais, but I don't think this was a robbery in the same way that some people have called other fights in the past, like Pacquiao and Bradley. That was a robbery, that first fight they had. You know, you can't argue with any of the verdicts, because you can see people seeing it in all those ways.
There you have it. Stay tuned. People want to follow you on Twitter. Where do they go?
At Gareth A. Davies DT.
BigFaceReporting.com. Melly Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback.